Welcome to the weekend edition of National Focus. I'm Kadisha St. Louis. Coming up, the construction of the new Newton Primary School is complete and Mass Dominic 2016 officially launched. Stay with us for details of these and other stories after this.
Introducing the Government of Dominica Internal Directory mobile app, available for download from the Google Play Store, One Mobile Market, and the Government of Dominica's website. Access to all ministries and sub-departments' phone, email and office addresses and websites. Simply select a ministry and the sub-department. You can dial directly from the app or save the numbers to your phone contacts. It's convenience at your fingertips.
You have my passport ready for pickup? Good. It really works.
Download the Government of Dominica Internal Directory mobile app today.
Thanks for staying with us. The Honorable Minister for Tourism and Urban Renewal, Robert Tung, has commended the decision made by government to amend the Income Tax Act, Chapter 701 of the 1990 Revised Laws of Dominica. According to the Honorable Prime Minister and Minister for Finance, Roosevelt Skerritt, the new bill is to include a new Section 26A, which will provide exemption on the payment of income and withholding tax on income accruing to owners for the rental of villas in an approved villa development for a period of 10 years. Honorable Tung notes that this change can prove very fruitful for Dominica's business economy.
This is one of the important incentives that the business community feels that is important to help to continue to create a enabling environment for businesses to strive. Obviously, the role of the government is to create that enabling environment, and the role of the private sector is to capitalize on that enabling environment. So we are happy and we are proud to be able to sit down here today, especially when these are one of the measures that we spoke about in the budget. And again, it goes to show that the government of Dominica is very serious and very focused in terms of the actions that we plan to put in place.
Honorable Tung believes that this bill will be beneficial towards the development of residential tourism in Dominica.
And that is one of the perfect avenues for persons who are interested in coming to live in Dominica for extended periods to be able to invest in this villa type developments. And what does this do? It helps to increase employment through the creation of jobs, through the construction. And even after the construction, you have persons who are going to come to Dominica to live in Dominica for extended periods of time, who will be hiring persons to take care of their homes, to buy food, to rent vehicles, to engage and see different sites.
The minister was speaking during Parliament last Thursday. Construction on the new Newton Primary School is complete. This was confirmed by the Honorable Minister for Education and Human Resource Development, Peter Seja, in an interview with the GIS News on Friday.
Works on the Newton Primary School have basically come to an end with the construction of the roadway. One aspect of the project that needs to be addressed is the fencing of the facility. However, all things being equal, in the new school year, we should see some movement as far as the occupation of the building is concerned. It is our hope that the students, teachers, and management of the Newton Primary School will move to their new facilities, and that the old teachers' campus at Bath Estate will be solely for the use of the Peter Savan Primary School. This for us is a major accomplishment, and we look forward with anticipation to actually moving the Newton Primary School into their new facility.
Mass Dominic 2016 was officially launched on Thursday, December 3rd, under the theme, The Spirit of the Real Mass. Speaking at the launching ceremony, the Honorable Minister for Tourism, Senator Robert Tung, solicited the participation of all Dominicans towards the successful Mass Dominic 2016.
In conclusion, I wish to state that the staging of the successful Mass Dominic 2016 will necessitate all hands on deck. The Ministry of Tourism can do it by themselves. You can do it as yourselves, as the contestants, as the organizers. Everybody has to put their hands together. Many hands make light work. Dominica may have been rattled by Erica, however, we are now counter-punching as we all seek to bounce back in a vigorous fashion from the latest setback. Violence against any individual should not be tolerated, should never be tolerated, especially against minors and our beautiful women. We will work closely with the police and the other stakeholders to ensure that our carnival is a safe one and free from violence. The government of Dominica is committed to continue supporting not only carnival but our culture, and will continue to do all in its power to take it to the best levels.
The minister encouraged the private sector to make a meaningful contributions towards the festivities. Acting Chief Cultural Officer Jacinta David spoke on behalf of the Honorable Minister for Culture, Justina Charles. She highlighted the role of government in preserving the true essence of Dominica's carnival, the Old Mass.
For the Real Mass 2016, we are looking to stage a festival in the eastern village of Castlebruce on Tuesday, February 2nd. Over the next few weeks, more details will become available as we deepen discussions with the stakeholders in that community. The Division of Culture is also paying attention to training and documentation of the traditional mass. The Old Mass and Sense Festival provides such an opportunity. Earlier this year, the division worked with relevant stakeholders of the Kalinago community and the Discover Dominica Authority to organize a very successful Tet Mass workshop in the Kalinago territory.
Kathleen Cuffey John-Jules, a product promotions manager of the Discover Dominica Authority, says the participation of the private sector in Mass Dominic 2016 is so far encouraging. Mass Dominic headline sponsor Flow, formerly Lime, has pledged to contribute $200,000 towards the celebrations.
We stand for more than cutting a check and making a presentation to the outdoor partners. This is about ensuring that the resources we invest in whatever we support, and in this particular instance we speak to Carnival, goes towards adding value to the product, goes towards adding value to our country and our communities. And certainly we commit to stand together with the DDA, stand together with the DFC, to ensure that we help bring the capacity, the skills, the knowledge, to ensure that we have a successful program in 2016.
The official opening of Carnival is carded for January 16th. However, activities will run from December 5th, beginning with the Calypso eliminations. The parade of costume bands to the streets of the capital will be held on February 8th and 9th, 2015. You're watching National Focus. When we return, meet the six vying for Miss Dominica 2016.
Protection from abuse is every child's right. Everyone has a shared responsibility in protecting the child from abuse.
Mothers, believe your children when they say they've been abused and follow through with child abuse cases when they've been reported.
For more information on child abuse or to report suspected cases on child abuse, contact the Social Welfare Division on 33 Great Marlborough Street or call 266-3020 or 266-3080.
Welcome back. The Honorable Minister for Education and Human Resource Development, Peter Seja, says his ministry continues on its drive towards a technical and vocational education and a training, TVET. In an interview with GIS News on Friday, the Honorable Minister gave details on efforts made thus far.
We train our workforce in preparation for what is presently offered out there. There is also the aspect of retooling the individuals who are already within the workforce. With TVET, there was the need to set up a TVET council. And recently, we established the TVET council, and we have set up the secretariat, which is mandated by the coordinator. We are happy to note that the staff out there has faced the challenge and are moving forward with ensuring that TVET becomes the thing in education and, of course, employment creation within the Commonwealth of Dominica and further afield.
In more news, the six contestants vying for the title of Miss Dominica 2016 were officially presented at the launching ceremony of Miss Dominica 2016 on Thursday. They are Julie Tuse, representing the community of Saint-Sauveur, Mona Christmas of Campbell, Noana Shillingford of Loubière, Brittany Farrow, representing Granby, Abigail Shillingford, representing Goodwill, and Tasia Flosak, representing the community of Castle Comfort. Take a look as contestants present their platforms.
For this year's pageant, my platform is empowering youth through leadership. As a former leader in my academic past, I see this platform most fitting as the prosperity of a nation relies on its youth, and we all must play our part to ensure that our youth are well-rounded and nurtured into nation building.
I'm one of six young ladies who will vie on the night, but my aspirations go beyond as I use my platform of self-motivation to inspire every Dominican from Portsmouth in the north to Scottsdale in the south and touching the eastern and the western coast of our beloved Nature Isle to go after their dreams, propelling them into reality.
For the 2016 Miss Dominica pageant, my platform is environmental conservation. Climate change is a very important and pressing issue today. And if we don't start to take steps to alleviate the man-made causes of climate change, the world as we know it will literally cease to exist. I love my country, Dominica, and I want to help preserve its indigenous and unique plant and animal life.
My platform is rising above the circumstances around you. A platform which speaks out to young individuals as well as adults who may feel that their dreams are unobtainable because of the fateful limitations that the people around them have placed upon their own lives and because of the limitations around them.
My platform is centered around youth culture unity. I believe it is very important to conserve our culture in the youth of today. I urge each and every one of you to come and support me and the five other beautiful contestants as we vie for the title of Miss Dominica.
I was raised in an extended family and thus saw it fit to promote this platform, embracing the role of the extended family in building a resilient society. I take this opportunity to invite everyone, not just on the night of the show, but our entire journey. Come support us as we make our contribution to the real mass and as we vie for the coveted title of Miss Dominica 2016.
The Queen Show pre-show, which provides an opportunity for the ladies to receive a sponsorship, is carded for December 19th. The Miss Dominica pageant is carded for February 5th, 2016. For a recap of this week's headline stories, we'll now join Kimani Seja.
Welcome to this week's edition of Flashback. In the headlines this week, the Ministry of Health launched the 2015-2016 Oral Health Survey. The survey will be conducted from 8th December 2015 to 18th February 2016. The act to sanction over $38.5 million from the consolidated funds of Dominica for the year ending June 2015 was passed last Friday. The largest appropriation of the supplementary estimates went to the Ministry of Finance with over $13 million, followed by the Ministry of Employment and the Ministry of Housing with over $7 million. The Office of the President and President's Charities Foundation brought early Christmas to several institutions this week. Presentations were made to the Dominica Infirmary, the Alpha Center in Goodwill, and Abilities Unlimited, formerly known as the Home for the Blind. The National Abattoir, which is currently in testing phase, is already providing opportunities for Dominicans. Honorable Acting Prime Minister Colleen McIntyre revealed at the House of Parliament last week that birds and pigs are currently being slaughtered at the facility. Honorable McIntyre says there is a sure market for the produce and encouraged Dominicans to support local. The world recognized World AIDS Day this week. The Honorable Health Minister, Dr. Kenneth Darrow, says in Dominica, the prevention of mother-to-child transmission of HIV/AIDS has been the most successful program, with no babies being born HIV positive during the period 2005 to 2013. The government of Grenada continues to contribute to Dominica's relief efforts post-Tropical Storm Erica. On Tuesday this week, Minister of State in the Ministry of Youth, Sports and Religious Affairs in Grenada, Senator Winston Garraway, presented a check of $100,000 to the Honorable Acting Prime Minister, Dr. John Colin McIntyre. These were just some of the headline stories making the news this week. For details of each of these stories and others, visit our website or Facebook page. It's back to you, Khadisha.
Thanks, Kimani. Coming up next, Creole Highlights with Macpherson St. Luce.
Hello, tout le monde. Bienvenue à ces nouvelles en Creole. Non, moi, c'est Macpherson St. Luce. Premièrement, Government Housing Loans Board a fait plus aisé pour servant public, bâti Kazayo. Chairman Board la Felix Thomas a fait parole que tout ça possible sinon l'antéwe loan qui baisse en l'antéwe yo.
Government Housing Loans Board, ça c'est une institution, gouvernement qui a fait public servant la pour bâti kay, pour koyo, avec pour famille. Avec ça qui a affecté. Commerce batikai c'est pourcent sa ka ki interest rate ki to ho so sa nou ka try fè nou ka try baisse moun apreza ka paye sa ka 7 avec 7.5% actuellement nou ka mené sa pou 5.5% so sa ki ndyo yo ke ni pou paye mwes la ha anou di si moun ni on loan pou 250 000 dollars pour 300 mois pour payer ça. Ça ou que trouvé que moun sa te ke ka paye 1 800 dollars tous les années. Mais avec ça nous ka ba yo à présent, yo ke paye 300 dollars moins parce que ça yo ka paye.
Thomas aussi fait parole que maison neuf que bâti, c'est l'initiative neuf ça là. Et aussi qu'à complimenter le gouvernement pour ça.
Moi, ça c'est moi décembre. Nous qui avons ahodi 25 cailles qui bâti tout en pays là. Avec nous qui premier 4 mois en année là, ahodi 17 millions de dollars. Nous qui avons dépensé 17 millions de dollars à l'an nous qui avons bâti pour pâti. Pour bâtir kay. So ça c'est un bon bagage pour pays là si nous ka garder ça qui ka fait avec kay c'est pas ça qui en luxury. On moun besoin en kay, c'est un bagage moun besoin avec nous content que nous taper là ça pour aider moun bâtir kay. Adan en puis yo ça pay vivre avec gouvernement housing loans board qui ka fait ça. Moi les oui merci Premier ministre, Prime Minister Roosevelt Skerritt, avec le Minister of Finance, avec Ibanou Douala pour taper la hansa, nous a metté pour aider moun, pour batikay, pour koyo, avec pour famille.
En autre nouvelle, même parlement pour Tisaban, Honorable Dr. Kenneth Darrow, car oui merci, résident de Big pour patience à yo, et puis comprenement depuis Erika. Honorable Darrow, c'était même comité gouvernement qui visitait Petro Casa qui a bâti pour yo en Gwambe.
Je voulais remercier ces monde là, ces monde de Bicla pour une instance pour patience et understanding yo parce que moi savent que c'est pas aisé pour la carrière 100% sans monde dans Yanti Hall et ben comme tout dit même si a monté un 6 bedroom mansion à ben one bedroom am chak à casa monde c'est casa monde ben ça c'est comporté ça c'est ça so moi savent pas aisé actuellement pour la carrière dans car pour 3 mois actuellement mais je j'ai dit moi donc on est patient c'est vrai que quand yo ouais travail commencer à les projets là, so, vous savez que yo excité avec nous avec le gouvernement, nous t'es toujours dit que nous avons ça à opportunité, à chance pour élever un standard living ces monde de là, parce qu'on nous savait que c'était un village qui était toujours derrière ces places, c'est un petit bagage, ça là. So actuellement nous avons une opportunité pour nous élever yo, pour nous mettre yo en à ça nous avons on pas ever laisser un pays.
Dans la nouvelle, habitant Dominique a tapé bon avis qu'a consigné le management Black Sugar Token. selon officier Cardi Gregory Linton, ça fait d'il fin autant important pour contrôler maladie là. Yoto l'occasion habitant en Calibishi, formé par workshop des semaines qui était organisé pour monde agriculteur et puis pour Hot Cardi. Participants visitaient l'occasion de l'Est Warrington en Calibishi, habitant qui a tapé succès selon bon weg et qui a suivi. Yon autre bagaille qui a concerné Cardi, c'est l'occasion qui a abandonné et puis habitant qui n'a pas suivi bon weg. Quand même, officier Linton qui a avisé habitant, que yo sa tapé bon résultat si yo fait application bon angwe et puis couper fait c'est dawe là qui affecté et puis finalement gouvernement Dominique tapé assistance aux machines la glace Hot Japan pour faciliter kay poisson en marigot machine sans là qui assisté faciliter là chain poisson bien frais parole ça là sorti au ministre pêche honorable Johnson Drago.
Eh ben oui comme ça gouvernement Japan qui a toujours aidé nous à faire pêcher à Dominique. Et bien, nous, juste après au Japon, nous avons créé une ice machine, un fisheries complex marigot, pour aider à pêcher, pour protéger les poissons. Là, nous avons créé la mer, et bien, là, nous avons sorti la mer pour si nous pouvons vendre poissons. Aussi, le gouvernement du Japon a donné l'argent pour manger tous ces complexes. Poisson à nous ni à Dominique, car c'est un roseau, un marigot, et un gotance. Yo qui vini, yo qui changé tous ces équipements, nous ni pour ces frisas là, et tous les équipements nous ni à ces raccourci fishland inside ça. Gouvernement Japon qui dépense l'argent sur ça, nous.
On a le droit, go quoi, monsieur Japon pour donation ça là.
Et moi le dit, gouvernement Japon. Et bien, mon Japon, merci pour tous ces supports là, yo kaba Dominique, ça fait poisson. Comme ça, nous, ka fait bon en poisson. Dans les ça, Dominique, ouais, plus qui 6,5 millions de dollars en valeur l'argent, nous fait en poisson pour dans les ça. Et bien, ça, bon pour la place poisson à Dominique.
Mais c'est mesdames, ça c'est tout pour nouvelles en créole pour à présent. Non, moi, c'est Mac Fossil Sennos. Ni un bon week-end. Au revoir.
Take time for you this Christmas. We'll tell you how to do just that on today's tip of the day coming up next. We're conditioned to think that Christmas is all about giving. So how about taking the time to give to yourself as well this year? Take a few moments in the day to practice meditation or stress-relieving breathing techniques. And that's all for this edition of National Focus. We always welcome your suggestions and comments. Drop us an email at gis@dominica.gov.dm or visit our website news.gov.dm. Like our Facebook page, facebook.com/gisnewsdominica, and follow our Twitter at gisdominica. You can also catch up on past National Focus newscasts on our GIS Dominica YouTube channel. From all of us here on the GIS News Production team, I'm Kadisha Senhui. Thanks for watching and have a great weekend.